KTV San Diego, Dave, Shelley, and Chainsaw on April Fool's Day, you boob! Come on!
I didn't realize Abramowitz did not know.
No. Boob! His mother called up.
Oh, no.
So excited. She calls up so excited, saying, oh, I can't wait to go out and see him.
Yeah.
And Shooty says to her, how far do you have to drive? Channel 10 calls up.
Yeah.
Rhett, who was out here.
Oh, yeah, for the Abramowitz Street.
Says, where's it going to happen? I'm there.
Yeah.
Shooty says to him, look, I don't want you to get RF'd at work over this thing. So,
right.
Look, I'm not saying anything, but just look at your calendar.
Yeah.
So Rhett goes, it's Thursday. Shooty goes, yeah.
Yeah.
He goes, April 1st.
Yeah.
Oh. And then there might have been a cuss word. I don't know.
Oh.
Hey, buddy.
What's happening?
Are you getting, you coming back home?
Yes, we actually, the chariot is awaiting for Abramowitz to finish autographing. He's got a throng. They don't care about me. It's Abramowitz. It's all Abramowitz. I pulled up the car. I'm his caddy right now.
Get my car, boy. And shine my shoes. So.
Wow.
I don't understand why you would take me seriously on this day.
Yeah,
that's the thing.
I know.
But my round, personal round of applause to Shooty. Yeah.
Good job.
Kelly.
Good job. Thank you.
Boyer.
Thank you.
And Chainsaw. And Dangerous Dick.
Good job. Absolutely.
And special thanks to Abramowitz for being such a boob. Oh, Dave.
Oh, Dave.
Dave.
He didn't fall for something on April Fool's Day, did it, Dave? Oh.
I heard he was out there in a lawn chair with sunglasses and a cocktail waiting for it.
Indeed he was.
And a corncob pipe, like...
He
had a corncob pipe and sunglasses and a little sailor hat like General MacArthur in his glory waiting for me to fall out of the plane. How horrible the sound of my voice on a microphone must have been.
That's too bad.
Is he there yet?
No, let's get him. Could you call Abramowitz over here?
Yeah.
Bad
honking for him.
Well, let's do it. Let's do it today. Come on,
there
is no naked skydiver.
Yeah, I know.
I don't know anybody who does that.
I know.
It's all been a joke.
I know. I know.
But it's now getting inside the vehicle.
You
get the rocket.
Well,
that's
so
cool.
Thank you very much.
Here, take the phone.
I wasn't playing.
You want to see my,
take the phone.
No,
take my pants
that's okay.
Off?
No, that's okay.
You were begging to me before.
Well, I know, but I because, you know, you're a married man and, you know, the whole
come
bit
on,
and all that.
Come on.
Hey, I've had enough crank for 1 week, okay?
Abramowitz?
What?
Huh?
Hey, you know what? Hey, you know what?
What?
Huh? Jesse, you want to take the bet? The naked skydiving bet?
There is no naked... Oh, he doesn't get it. It was all pretend.
Right.
And we all knew it. Everyone knew it except you.
Yeah.
And I think a couple people out in the hallway who were stunned when I lost the bet. Tree freaked out.
Wow, Dave's golfing really sucks. What happened?
Abramowitz must really suck.
Right. Oh. Well, that was glorious.
Good grief.
That was beautiful. And by the way, happy anniversary.
Thank you very much, Shelley. Same to you and to the Chainsaw. 9 years ago today, we started this very radio broadcast. 9 years ago today,
yeah.
April 1st, 1990.
Was this like copper or something? Flip you a penny?
Yeah, here's a penny.
Whatever.
Like you would even.
Well, no,
it's my penny.
I just don't celebrate. I don't have occasion to celebrate anniversaries other than my birthday or family birthdays or something like that. So
anniversary of the day that you went into menopause.
Thank you very much. Thanks a lot.
Hey, Ruth, I'll bet you got suckered in on that, didn't you?
I did. Ruthie!
What a boob!
I'm an idiot. I went in to tell the boys, the producers, to tell Rick. I went and they go, and they all three, first of all, Rick's looking at me like, no kidding, oh, that's great. And producer Mark goes, you idiot. It's April Fool's Day. I already knew it was, but it was so, you guys acted it all so beautifully. I went for it. It just was perfect.
Could you hear the plane?
Yeah, sort of, yeah.
I had plane noise, and then when I opened the door, I had Boyer's office fan. I just held the phone down by a fan. That's all I did. Oh, I'm scared. Oh, we're high up.
Oh, golly. Oh,
such
gee.
You know, knowing all along that you were going to do this, and you had me when you started pretending to put the harness on. That was very convincing. I'm like, damn it, he's really up there. Oh, wait, I knew about this.
Oh, wait, no, he's not.
Oh, yeah, wait a minute. No,
he's not. He's in the room with me.
That's right. He's right next to me.
How many people showed up?
We had a guy on the phone. Who said it looked like it was opening day of the races.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. We haven't had such a successful one in years.
Is that where people normally park for the Speedway?
Yeah, there are two grandstands and two parking lots, but that's the big one. That's the bigger of the two.
I don't remember what year it was that I did the space shuttle. Was it 92?
I think it was.
Or 91? I haven't been...
It might have been 91. No...
91 or 92.
91 or 92, early on, yeah.
I haven't been able to get anybody to fall for anything since then.
That's true.
And it was just long enough, the 7-year itch.
Yes. See? See? That's the formula.
Boobs! Good God!
I mean, I was even waiting for it and everything. And
Rudy! 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 Rudy!
The worst part about that is I kind of told her that something was going on today.
Well, yeah,
and she still fell for it.
I knew something was, but Yeah, well, you just pulled it off so good.
Yo,
you did.
And the beauty
my
of
job.
It is the weeks and the just the little seeds that you planted early on, like months ago.
I started telling Abramowitz a month ago that I wanted a naked skydive. Yeah. I had people emailing me.
Yeah.
I don't know anybody. Nobody.
Of course not.
Not a person. Not a single one.
And then when Abramowitz just played into our collective hand and said, oh, streak if Duke doesn't win, and then the basketball gods that are with us, and he actually has to streak. It was just perfect.
The timing was unbelievable.
It really was.
It's very clear that God wanted me to win.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
I'll tell you what, and the other thing about this, Abramowitz saying, come on, let's do it for real, let's do it for real. I would never, ever, in a million years, be so stupid as to actually take a naked skydiving bet, ever.
Would you ever even skydive with clothes?
No!
See, I wouldn't either.
No!
I wouldn't either. Airplanes are great to fly in. You don't jump out of them!
No!
Unless they're on fire!
Unless you have to!
Right!
Right!
And
even then, you wait till the very last minute.
Sure you do!
And you're like 10 feet from the ground. You just jump out.
I know! I agree.
Oh, my God.
Well, thanks, everybody, for coming out. And I especially want to thank the people who showed up asking, hey, this isn't an April Fool's gag, is it?
No! No! Uh-oh. You can be first in line right over there. That's where the LZ is. Go ahead.
Oh, that's funny.
No, here's a free T-shirt. Look up in the sky. There's Dave.
Huh? What?
What do the T-shirts look like? I haven't seen them.
The T-shirts have the Dave Shelley and Chainsaw logo on the front, on the left breast, and on the back it says, big letters, I got fooled by Dave Shelley and Chainsaw, April 1st, 1999.
Not even a stick figure of you skydiving naked?
I don't know if they did that or not, but it was if they would have, it would have been a pretty big stick. Hey, it's time to do sports with a chainsaw who is on the road. Now, I know you are without all your resources here, but can we do a light touch, a recap on sports?
Absolutely.
The chainsaw, who played it off masterfully, by the way. Nicely done.
Thank you.
Chainsaw is the unsuspecting man on the scene into the lion's den, because sometimes that can turn ugly, but you know what?
Yeah.
Our people are pretty cool when they find out they've been had.
Yeah.
Oh, you know what else was good was the Donman plug.
That's right.
The Nimnod plug.
The Nimnod plug, yeah. Remember, you told people that, and this was probably in 96 or 95, you told people that there would be a way that they could put the Donman plug.
No, this is in 1991.
Was it really?
Our first year.
Really?
Yeah.
That's right. That's how old the Nimnod is. Yeah,
yes.
I remember that.
There's a special plug you could get at Radio Shack.
Mm-hmm. And people could then see us in their radios?
No, no, no. You put it on your TV and you can see us doing our radio show.
Right, right, right.
Yeah.
Oh, brother.
Exactly.
It's the Donman plug, which backwards spells Nimnod.
If people were lined up at radio, open, 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 must get Donman plug.
And it was pouring rain.
I know.
Oh, my
and people
God.
Were standing out in line waiting for the Radio Shack to open.
Jesus.
Beautiful.
Oh, the fun of it all.
And then, you know what? We had a few years where this holiday fell on a weekend, so we didn't do anything.
Yep.
But this was superb.
And then the one year that you left before, right before. And then another year that it was the very first day at a new station, so you didn't do one because everybody thought it was a joke.
That's right.
And then last year we did the switch. We were on AM 600.
Right, that was
on this day last year.
Yeah.
And absolutely refused to believe that we were. No, we're not. We're not on AM, we're on FM, you boo.
What
are you talking about?
Yeah, that was fun.
What happened to my news programs that I like so much? Why am I have to listening to these caustic, foul-mouthed morons on my program?
Where's Paul Harvey?
We were playing, like, Cat Scratch Fever. And...
Oh, good heavens! Get me another diaper.
Well, happy anniversary to everyone who's been listening for these many years. 9 years ago today, we started this very radio show here in San Diego. And it's been such fun.
And you know what? Thanks to Chainsaw for choosing us. Because really, it was he who put it all together.
Thank you, Chaney.
We weren't his first choices, though.
Not. And of course, he's done nothing since then, but whatever.
All right. We still have Win a Wad. We've got to kick that off today.
Oh, yeah, right.
Now, let me tell you the official rules of engagement of April Fool's are.
Yeah.
If you're fooling someone,
that's
perfectly fine.
Yeah.
But if you tell someone in advance, look, this is not an April Fool's Day gag,
right,
then you are committed to reality.
Okay.
Okay?
All right.
And this is not an April Fool's Day gag. This is just another example of brilliant programming by Matt Littles to start his money game on April 1st.
That's just heads up thinking.
Shelly with sustained applause.
It's just heads up thinking.
Hang on a second here. Meredith, are you there?
Yeah.
Hi.
Hi, how are you?
I'm doing great. How are you?
We're awesome. That was awesome.
Did you go out to see me naked?
Oh, yeah, right.
Atta girl.
No, actually, it was awesome. The look on Abramo's face was just wonderful.
When I said
that
April Fool's?
That was the best gag yet. That was awesome. And thanks for the cool shirt. It was awesome.
Oh, you did get fooled. All right.
No, it was awesome.
Thanks, Meredith. See? She's very sweet.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. Took a big hunk out of her morning, and she's still cool about it.
Happy about it. Well, and you know what? I'm jealous that I didn't get to see the look on Abramowitz's face.
Oh.
What? Oh, gosh darn it. Oh.
I couldn't decide between, and April Fool's, you dumb bastard.
I think you did both.
All right. Go to the Sports Network. Here is the Chainsaw, the 101.5 KGB. Good morning.
Good morning, and thank you very much, Dave Rickard, Shelley Dunn, Chris Boyer, Ruth 66, Shooty God, and of course, Abramowitz in the sports world. Well, there's some baseball and there's some basketball. So, Abramowitz, how do you feel right now? He's sitting there recoiled in my passenger seat. Sorry. I feel like a jerk.
Hey, Abramowitz. I can still see your penis in my mind.
Me too.
Flippity, floppity, dingity, dongity.
And I got to tell you, the expression on his face was wonderful on the April Fool's payout. He was looking around, craning his neck, because there were literally two airplanes coming toward us, one in particular. And like I mentioned earlier, there was one guy with a telescope that was looking up and said, oh, sure enough, his hatch is open. I said, hey, Abramowitz, you know, putting it in his face afterwards, he said, hey, Abramowitz, don't you know you can't skydive on a flight path? And it's like, well, you're here, buddy.
What did he say?
Well, you're here, buddy. Yeah, because you're in on the joke.
It was just a wonderful, and the KGB promotion staff was just outstanding, and the people were in very good spirits. They took it in stride, especially when handed the wonderful gratuity of the very, somehow, miraculously quickly made Dave Shelley and Chainsaw T-shirt. Which I didn't see. Which I didn't see, by the way.
You don't get one.
Well, I would have... You know, if I had seen the stupid shirts, I would have realized what you were doing.
You really think so? Wow. You're pretty smart, huh?
Hello?
Yeah, you know, the wonderful thing is I think we can fashion him an I Got Fooled by Dave Shelley and Chainsaw thong. What do you think of that?
We can get him an I Got Fooled by Dave Shelley and Chainsaw wardrobe. How's that?
Yeah.
All right, guys, well, come on back home. We miss you already.
You got that right.
All right.
This is 9:25 and 2 seconds, and this is your 101 KGB FM Sports.
Oh, my.
This comedy.
We're going to do Win a Wad before 10 o'clock, and I'm not kidding you. It's not an April Fool's Day joke there.